our organisation, ADS, looks after aerospace. That's both civil aviation and space, defence and security. We have about 900 companies in direct membership. And we also look after the interests of a number of smaller SMEs, small and medium-sized enterprises, that operate in the supply networks of the bigger companies. And there's probably around about 2,500 to 3,000 of those in UK as well. So it's a fairly large organisation that we endeavour to help. The problem at the moment, if there is a problem that's specific to us, is that our government is tight on cash and flow at the moment. Doesn't mean to say that spending has stopped, that's not so. But there are very few new orders. Things are being wound down, and that's general across international space. So to be able to maintain competitive edge, technology advance, the capability, we're looking to be able to spread that technology of advanced engineering on an international basis. And that's absolutely important. I think the other thing that we're looking for too is to strengthen markets and partner with other companies in other countries so that we can bring a wealth of experience of the advanced engineering together and together go forward, investing in the future, investing in technology for the longer term. Okay, ADS have a number of relationships with different nationalities in the environment, and the bigger ones are with Malaya, Singapore, and Australia, New Zealand. But I think that's an important thing for the region, that it's through organisations such as ADS that you can get into our companies. And our companies are find it easier to deal in the first instance through a trade body such as ours and with a national trade body to make those connections. Because in dealing with security and defence matters, it needs to be seen to be done above board and with the right permissions. And that eases all that process if it's done through those who know. So ADS stands ready to help anybody who wishes to make an approach to UK. And we're also helping and here with about 64 UK companies who are looking to expand into this region.